19 individuals are apprehended by authorities for operating fake notary services without the presence of licensed attorneys. Nico Bawa reports.
The NBI Special Task Force caught these suspects on video allegedly processing these documents to be notarized. They were reportedly using dry seals and signed the notarized documents themselves. Their transactions were stopped when the NBI agents who posed as clients declared the arrest. The Integrated Bar of the Philippines filed a complaint against the suspects. 8 tables and 2 stalls were being used for fake notaries beside a wet market in Muñoz, Quezon City. According to one suspect, while no lawyer was on site, she insisted that their business is legitimate. The NBI, however, discovered that their business permit has expired.
Secretary lang kami, sir.
Pero kayo po ng notary mismo?
Nagtatatak lang, pero siya po yung pumipirma, pinapadala namin sa kanya pag mga masela.
The NBI, however, explained that their business is illegal.
Pwedeng secretary tumatanggap, no? Pwede, magandang alibay yan. But then, they were personally observed by the team na sila na rin ang pumipirma doon sa notaryo. That should not be done. Hindi sila kumukuha na ng ID ng nagpapanotaryo sa kanila. Basta pagka pinresenta yung papel, hindi nila alam kung yun ba yung tao o hindi. They just notarize it.
The NBI says the suspects were using the names of 3 lawyers for the notaries. They will be summoned to explain their side.
So may mga lawyer na tumawa, kaya lang nung na-inform sila na may IBP rito, ganyan, nag-hold off sila. So hindi nila tinuloy. Although identified namin sila, sabi ko nga kanina, ongoing yung investigation namin.
According to some applicants, notaries can be expensive depending on the lawyer, which is why they look for fake notaries. The IBP, however, warned that fake notaries can cost more because it will make their transactions invalid.
Ang mga faking notaryo ay nagbibigay ng kapahamakan sa mga ating mga mamamayan dahil nagiging questionable yung kanilang mga dokumento at paari itong maging sanhi ng kaguluhan, at hindi paniniwala ng mga publiko sa notary.
The suspects were jailed and charged with usurpation of authority, falsification of public documents, and estafa. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.
More Filipinos from conflict-hit Lebanon arrive in Manila. The Migrant Workers Department says 290 Filipino workers and their families from Beirut returned home via government-chartered flight today. They were welcomed by several government officials, including Migrant Workers Chief Hans Leo Kakdak and Health Secretary Teodoro Herbosa. This raises to 950 the number of Filipinos repatriated from Lebanon in the wake of escalating tensions between Israel and Hezbollah militants. The Philippine government previously assured affected Filipinos of support once they return home. Now here's a reminder to gas up this weekend. Pump prices expect to move next week, as estimates show the price of diesel and kerosene could go up by up to 50 centavos per liter. Gasoline, meanwhile, could be unchanged or see an increase of 20 centavos also per liter. Now, the looming hike comes after global oil prices saw a 4% gain this week, mainly on tensions in the Middle East and jitters on the U.S. presidential elections in November. Canada says it should have acted sooner to stem the flow of temporary migration into the country. Immigration Minister Mark Miller, however, rejects criticisms their immigration plan was rash and aggressive. Canada is slashing both permanent and temporary immigration to address concerns over a housing shortage as well as high costs of living. Southeast Asian nations will deploy air assets to the Philippines to support relief efforts after the storm. The Office of Civil Defense says Singapore, Brunei, Malaysia, and Indonesia pledge to help. The agency says the ASEAN member states will also send essential items for storm victims. Singapore's defense ministry confirmed it would send a C-130 aircraft, citing the deep bilateral and defense ties between Manila and the city-state. President Marcos wants to revisit the Bicol River Basin Development Program after seeing the widespread flooding caused by severe tropical storm Christine. The chief executive cited his project as he vowed aid to storm victims. Harleen Delgado has tonight's top story.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. traveled to Bicol today to see the situation firsthand after Storm Christine battered the region and triggered massive floods. Together with his cabinet members and local officials, the president assured evacuees at the Naga City Hall the national government will extend all necessary assistance.
Dumaan lang po ako para makita na yung mga dala namin na tulong at kayo eh, lahat kayo na kailangan mag-evacuate dahil nakalubog pa yung mga ibang bahay ninyo. Mabigat itong nangyari sa inyo at napakalaki ng tubig, kaya gagahanapan natin ng paraan yan.
During the situation briefing, Naga City Mayor Nelson Legacion said floods in the city reached as high as 12 feet, submerging 22 out of 27 barangays.
Sa ngayon, pitong barangay na lang po ang baha. Yung ilang portion ay hanggang dibdib pa rin. We may still be needing rescue boats kasi hindi pa po kami tapos sa rescue operation. Unprecedented po ito. First time na mangyari po sa aming lungsod.
Albay Acting Governor Gwen Ombongao also reported that over 92,000 families were evacuated in the province, with over 500 houses totally damaged. The estimated cost of damage to roads and bridges is 1.3 billion pesos, while agricultural damage is pegged at 10 million pesos. Both the Naga City and Albay government are requesting the Department of Social Welfare and Development for thousands of additional food packs for the affected residents.
We're okay, Mr. President. We're just having to use our Cebu center now to feed into Bicol.
After seeing the widespread flooding, Marcos stressed the need to focus on long-term flood projects, particularly the Bicol River Basin project.
We have to revisit it now. Iba na ang conditions ngayon. May flood control naman tayo eh. Pero hindi kaya yung ganito kadaming tubig. Hindi talaga kaya. Kasi never naman, walang forecast na ganito eh. Ito, climate change talaga ito. This is all new.
Floods in San Fernando and Midoor in Camarines Sur have slightly subsided, but some houses are still submerged in water. In Bula, Camarines Sur, some villages are also inundated. Residents here are in need of food and clean water.
Wala po kaming pagkain, tubig, kung ano-ano. Wala man lang ayudang nadating. Kailangan po namin ng pagkain.
In Albay, clearing operations are underway in areas where landslides occurred. Power supply has been restored in Libon and Bolangi, but affected residents are appealing for more aid and basic necessities.
Sa katotohanan po, nagkakaubusan na ng supply ng bigas, gayon din ng gasolina at krudo. Kaya naman ang mga lokal na tindahan, hindi na po nagpapabili ng kanilang bigas. Kaya ang mga residente po, lalo sa coastal area, ay problemado sa kanilang pang-araw-araw na pangkonsumo.
Jorlin Delgado, ABS-CBN News.
The death toll due to severe tropical storm Christine has climbed to 81, but this number still needs to be validated, according to the Office of the Civil Defense. The number of missing persons also went up to 34. The National Disaster Management Agency says over 4 million people were affected by the storm, internationally known as Trami. Flooding was also reported in nearly 2,000 villages across the country. The country's agriculture sector also suffered 87 million pesos worth of damage due to Christine. Government data show over 1,600 hectares of crops have been affected, impacting more than 3,000 farmers. The Agriculture Department says rice and corn fields in the Bicol region and Mimaropa sustained the most damage. In northern Luzon, agri losses reached 2.6 million. The Agriculture Department has vowed assistance to farmers and fisherfolk. It plans to request an additional 1 billion pesos from the Budget Department for the rehabilitation of the affected agricultural areas. Damage to infrastructure, meanwhile, was pegged at 203 million pesos. The Philippine grid operator says transmission services in Luzon are now back to normal after the onslaught of Christine. The NGCP says full services were restored early Saturday morning. The agency adds it was also able to find a technical solution in other affected areas such as Nueva Ecija, despite some ongoing repair in its lines. But the NGCP warns some technical issues in other facilities might still affect some areas.
Kung meron mga customers na wala pa silang serbisyo ng kuryente, maaring meron pang problema sa pasilidad ng kanilang mga electrical operatives or distribution utilities. Ang NGCP, siya yung highway na nagtatawid ng kuryente mula sa mga planta na nagpo-produce ng kuryente patungo dun sa mga distribution utility o electric cooperative. Kung maayos na yung highway, which is kami sa NGCP, pwede kasing yung mas maliliit na linya, meron pang problema. Kaya hindi pa nakakarating sa mga bahay natin yung kuryente.